children, how are you all? Okay, we are discussing about democratic and nationalistic revolution, paper 2 and lesson number 13. So in this, we already learned about the French Revolution. In the French Revolution, how they got, how the people were revolted and how they suppressed the people in French and what are the social economic conditions. We also learned yesterday, socio-economic conditions in French. There are three estates, I said. What are the three estates? One are clergy people and one is nobles. And third is third estate people. Third estate people comes under, all people are comes under here. The intellectuals of, landlords, businessmen, merchants, traders, landless laborers, workers, industrial workers, landless laborers, peasants, these are all coming to the third estate. Okay. So, how the treatment was happened for these three? Clergy people are enjoying the privileges and even nobles. Nobles are related to the king and relatives of the kings and all. And nobles are also leading a luxurious life. And third estate people, these landlords, intellectuals, middle class people, everyone, business people, merchants, traders, workers, landless laborers, agricultural laborers, these are all what they are doing. So, completely here, these two are maintaining a lot of, they are getting good privileges and they are leading luxurious life at that time. And only these people are, they will be more hard workers and they have to pay the tax. Because these people both are not paying taxes. So finally that burden is on these third estate people. And finally these are all paying taxes and at the same time the crops are failing. And people are suffering with the, and every time they are busy with the engaging with the wars, rulers. So such time shortage of food, everything. Crops were failed and nobody is taking care of the development of the third estate people. And also their lands, mainly these clergy people are, the churches have a lot of land and that land is tilled by these people. But they are not giving any own land or they are not giving any proper wages to them. Like that these third estate people are suffering. So, generally in any case, these people will be more and these two are first estate and second estate are very few. So, such a time what happened? These people got revolute. Right? And at the same time, we were talking about the real estate and social, these three estates and how the socio-economic conditions, particularly for third estate. And in that, from here, the slowly the started revolution from the third estate people. Why? There is a well, number of reasons we can see here. They are not paying taxes, both the first estate and second estate people, clergies and nobles. And that burden is on them only. And they have landless laborers. And people are poor. Isn't it? So such conditions, they definitely and obviously they will get revolted. Isn't it? The same thing happened in the French also. And at that moment, a growing middle class had to enter the privileges. In this, many educated people were growing and many philosophers, social thinkers and political philosophers were started writing some books that also yesterday I mentioned, like Rousseau, John Locke, and all they made some social content, one book, the treatise of government. In that particular books they have written and in that they were always talking about the government, how it is exploiting, the monarchy governments, how they are exploiting the people and everything they have written. So with that, their speeches and with their books, people were motivated and slowly even the education, growing middle class and educated people were growing and they were all set together. And finally they got revolted and here, the outbreak of revolution, just slowly that outbreak was a revolution was started. Well, it was started on 5th May, 1789, as Louis XVI, 1789 CE, Sir Louis XVI, he called all the estates, estate people for to increase the taxes or to talk about the taxes, he wanted to assemble all the three estate people. So, from first and second estate people, there were total 300 representatives from both these estate people. 300 representatives came here to the assembly. But there is a one big assembly hall, there they went. And the members were, there was a seating arrangement for 300 people, like they were sitting both rows are on opposite sides, and they were sitting, both these people were seated. And remaining from third estate people, almost 600 people from all categories of people, educated people, their members, the representatives came to that assembly, and they were not even, there is no seating arrangement for these 600 people. Okay, and not only that, and whoever came along with them in that, women and children are there, they were women and peasants were, they were completely, they were not allowed to enter the assembly. So that was, in that many educated people are there, they felt very bad for that, and along with that 600 representatives, they have brought 40,000 representative letters, they brought 40,000 letters which are representing their problems. Okay, so here there is no they are not given any importance or any privilege to them, so they got angry, and finally many people came out of the assembly. Why they came out of the assembly? It was already Louis Philippe was continuing for one vote, one value. Like that they have to represent the people. So here what happened, they are not giving any vote to these 600 people. So they got angry and they came back, and they were left the assembly, and they came back. That was the first revolution, the outbreak of the revolution of that time. And next is the 10th court of oath. So these people all were formed as a national assembly, and finally they came to a tennis court, a big open ground was there in Paris. There they went, and there they started, they declared as national assembly, their party. Like that they declared national assembly, and they were all of them in that, the three important persons are there. Who are there in that indoor stadium? They started one meeting, and that Mira Bio, Abby C.S. and Bailey. They declared themselves as National Assembly, and they swore not to back. They want to swear it and not to back to go to houses until unless they want a declaration of a constitutional drafting. That means they want to write a constitution immediately, then itself. So, what happened? They were busy to write all the rules and conditions of the constitution, declaration of constitution. In the meantime, in the same time what happened, it was extreme winter at that time, and the crops were completely failed. And these people are very busy to writing and drafting the constitution and all. At such a time, there was a big, and there was a lot of food shortage. Why the food shortage? This is the right time, because if any political disturbance in a country, the black marketers and some landlords, what they'll do? They will block the stock. So, like that, they stop blocking the stock for bread and butter. So immediately many people were completely, the black marketing was going on, and women and children were fed up with this situation, and they are all came out, and they started because they were standing in a long queue for a small piece of bread. There was a standing for hours in a long queue, but there was no use, they are not getting any food. So because of that they got revolted immediately, and at that time it was a severe winter, and the people are suffering with winter season, and no food shortage at all. And members of the National Assembly, at that time there was a revolution, very completely started, And finally, Louis XVI, there was a mandate for him, compulsorily he gave a recognition. He gave a resignation to his post. And immediately, they started France becomes a constitutional monarchy. France became the constitutional monarchy. So they have written the constitution almost 17 constitutional rights. How we have a fundamental rights, directive principles, how we have for our constitution. Like that they have written 14 constitutional rights. In that the 10 are important and they are mentioning here. So in this France became a constitutional monarchy in 1791 CE. 1791 CE, France became a constitutional monarch. And here also there is again bias. All the citizens who are completed 25 years age, for them only, they are called as active citizens. With to that active citizens family, they had a right to vote. Remaining women and peasants, they did not have any right to vote. So, okay, slowly that was happened after France became republic and all. So, here they have written some declaration of, they declared some fundamental rights. What are the fundamental rights? Right to live, right to work, and right to live. Actually, right to live is very important, right to live. And right to speech, they can express their opinion, isn't it? And all these things, by birth, see, how will get a human right? Being a citizen of that particular place or being a, by birth will get a human right, isn't it? Right to live means by birth will get that right. Nobody should deny that, isn't it? So such right to live, right to work, right to express their opinion, right to speech, okay? All the right to education, all these things automatically they have written in the in their declaration. So here again the active citizens and passive citizens. Who are the active citizens? Those who completed 25 years and who can pay more tax. Those people only had a right to vote. So remaining on, that is not a correct judgment, isn't it? It's not a justification. When in a class, if you, many children are there, if you take a few children and you select a leader in that, that is completely biased, isn't it? In democracy means we have to give a majority of opinion. Majority of opinion of people only we have to consider it. Otherwise, it is not at all a democracy. Again, it comes to monarch, isn't it? So, in such a situation, an active voice, passive citizens and active citizens, again there is a conflict. And finally, they have written about the declaration of rights of man and citizen. So, in that these 10 declarations we will discuss now. Only 10, not everything. 17 declaration of citizens are there, but only 10 we will mention it here. I'll explain each and everything. Men are born and remain free and equal in rights. So every man, though he is educated, irrespective of education, irrespective of gender, irrespective of whether they are staying in village or a town or city, whatever, irrespective of all the things, those who completed 20 years, they should have a right, 25 years, they should have a right to vote. That is one thing. And men will have a right to vote. Men means here men and women. Okay. And the aim of every political association is preservation of natural and inalienable rights of men. They are liberty, property, security and resistance to oppression. So here four things are there. Liberty, security, and resistance to oppression and property. Resistance to suppression. This is very important. What is resistance to suppression? Somebody is suppressing us. There is a right to resist ourselves. If somebody is killing us, then definitely we have to deny that, isn't it? So such resistance to suppression and property. If we have property, that should be our, that will be our own property. And security is very important. And liberty, liberty, we have a lot of liberty, but the thing is, it should not be harm to others. It should not be harm to others, and it should not be illegal to against the government. Then definitely we can use our liberty. So there are four rights: liberty, security, property, and resistance to suppression. And next is, liberty consists of the power to do whatever is not injurious to others. Whatever liberty we can take, but it should not be injurious to others. It should not be illegal. You can work anywhere, or for example, take India. If you can work anywhere in Jammu Kashmir or Arunachal Pradesh or Kanyakumari, wherever. But the thing is, it should not be illegal, or it should not be harm or injurious to others. So that is important. And next one is, the law has the right to forbid only actions that are injurious to society. And it should not be injurious to society also. If we are doing, if we are rolling some play, for example, you take TV series. They are taking more and more TV series, but it is a harm to the public, and they are mentally harassing the people. So that is also injurious to society. Or you are doing some criminal work, that is also injurious to society. Kidnapping, drug mafia, land mafia, these are all completely injurious to society. So when we are doing some work, it should not be injurious to society. That is one of the right. And no man may be accused, arrested, or detained except the case determined by the law. Nobody can arrest without arrest warrant, or nobody can accused or arrested or detained except in the case of determined by law. If law says that he is a criminal, till that time nobody can arrest him or nobody can accuse him. Okay, so that is very important. And and for the maintenance of public, every citizen may speak, write, print freely. He must take responsibility for the abuse of such liberty in case of disobedience of the law. So everybody have a right to speak, right to express their opinion. These are all comes under democracy. In democracy, people have equal rights. Anybody can speak. Anybody can involve in the politics. Anybody can contest in the elections. Everybody should have right, those who are completed prescribed age. So these are all, these rights are, we should have by inbuilt. They are, being a democratic country, it should have, definitely it should have. So everybody should, can say their opinion. They can say their opinion. They can speak. They can speak. They can associate from the people to do some good work, and all, we have every right that. And next, since property is sacred and inviolable right, no one may be deprived of it unless a legally established public necessity requests it. For example, if any temple is there, or any mosque, or any church, so we, if it is a common property of all people also, we should not destroy it, because that is harm to the one category of people, that self-respect of some category of people or some religious people. So we are not supposed to do that. So if it is a public property also, we should not harm that property. So like this, there are 17 rights are there in French Revolution. Finally, they have declared these rights, and in this tenure described here. Okay, I hope everyone understood, children. Thank you.